Dave TV, Kelechi, you're not going to get down on the floor today. You're not going
to. This love will be by force. Tell me now, now make I know. My brother. Arabanko. Trust me, it's allowed. Arabanko. I beg you, do it to you, right? Arabanko. Hey, my brother. Trust me, he's alive. Arabanko. I don't go kill, I don't go stress you. Arabanko. Now your choice.
I'm
very happy.
What do you think? It's a music video.
No, my brother, see. I was telling people about Eddie Nketiah. Eddie, call me. Nketiah, call me. You understand? I was telling you people. Allow the kid. You understand? His pressing game is mad. He was harassing them. You defend in football from the front. That is how you defend. You harass their players. They cannot build from the back. That is actually how you defend. That is his job in the team. Apart from scoring, the work rate has to be there. And that's what you have been telling the man then. Sometimes the football is not only about end product. It is the most important aspect of football, yes. But it's also
important for your striker.
Exactly what I'm saying. But again, if it's not happening for you, you have to still put the work in.
Yeah.
You have to run, drag the defenders, pull them apart, create spaces for your partners. That's what football is all about. And he's done that brilliantly. He is grabbing his chance.
Mm.
He wasn't given a chance in Leeds for some reason, but under Arteta, he scored goals.
Does he learn that sort of pressing at Leeds?
Because of course, remember, Bielsa is mad. He's my Leeds coach. You know, I'm my second team is third team. I don't know. I have affiliations with Leeds. You know, I used to work there. I used to steward there when I was younger, you know, in uni. So, I mean, and I used to watch him even when he was on. He was starting, you know, Bamford was starting ahead of him. I was upset by that because I believe the boy can do magic. And he harassed that goalkeeper into a mistake and he scored. And throughout the game, even till he was subbed off, he has a few chances where his decision making could have been better.
Yeah, you know, the one with Aubameyang. You thought he could have played.
He didn't see him because he was focused on the pass, focused on one being staying onside, to on the pass from Pepe, and then when he got it, decision making.
That's when you gotta get your head up, though,
isn't it? Yeah, but you know, it's a quick game. Yeah. We at home can be saying, oh, we have to do this, but you know, but again, he did well. But another player that for me dictated everything was Xhaka. He is too important to this side. And that's why you see me.
And that's another player. That's another player, isn't it? That Arteta has put faith in.
Of course.
Right? Like he's doing now at the moment with David Luiz.
Yeah.
Right? The other guy was in a similar circumstance was Xhaka, innit? It was like a lot of people wanted him gone after that incident. As soon as Arteta came in, he's like, nah, this guy's one of my main guys.
Exactly.
He's been out literally, you could say, for two games because even the first game, he was out literally at the start.
Yeah.
Amazing that he's recovered so quickly and he's back.
Yeah.
And he did solidify that midfield, didn't he?
Of course. The patterns, the pressing, everything, his passing was very good. He dictated the pace. And that's why I keep calling for support for these players. You know, they are not probably as bad as people think. Football is about confidence most times. You might have this. If they tell you Leicester will win the Premier League with their bunch of players, you say never. But they had the confidence to go for it. That's football for you. Somebody that you might think, I mean, obviously people don't rate Henderson, but personally, for instance, I rate him. The confidence is that he's balling. He's doing his job. He's not fancy. He can make fun of his running style and this stuff, but he's doing his job. It's about confidence. And today they gave it, they gave the whole confidence. Even Rob Holding that was being questioned and stuff, delivered. He claimed the man of the match. All the aerial balls. He won everything. So they had a point to prove today to the fans, to their manager who has been backing them, to everybody, the board, everybody. And I think they did so today. And we knocked him off the bench, another youngster, and delivered. So that is why I'm happy. We've not won in a very long time. You know, it looks like very, very long time. And I'm happy to just get this one out and then see if it can have a ripple effect.
FA Cup Sunday, would you go with a strong team?
Of course. That's the only route to enter Europe now. That's what it's looking like. And, you know, in as much as last weekend I was a bit too emotional and I was saying no Europe and all that, I think I need the European money now, now that I'm thinking about it. I don't know how much it is to qualify for Europa League and, you know, and all those money spin. I know we can't get Champions League. We have money problems in the team. So if we can get some money from Europa, why not? So go for it. Again, when you touch a trophy, when you lift a trophy, it kind of gives you confidence and a boost to go for more. So I hope that if they go for the FA Cup, it gives them a boost to pursue next season, you know, gallantly. But again, I'm really, really happy with what I saw today. I know that I oversang today, I think. But my brother, I'm really, really, really happy that the boys delivered. Thank you.